All right. I've got a few people asking about the driving operation, and that's just a quick walkthrough on this forwarder. So we got your parking brake and stairs. This is forward and reverse. Obviously throttle and brake, you're down on the floor. And this just has a little thumbstick for steering. And there's a few different things you can do. Right now I'm in low range, which is L tortoise mode. And that's right here on the screen. And I can adjust that. As long as I'm in the economy mode, I can use, as long as I'm not facing the boom and I'm driving, I can use my thumbstick right here, and that'll change that number right there. And that'll give me a little more throttle. Go a little quicker, a little slower, a little more power for climbing. You know, you lower it down a little bit, you got a little more grunt and not as much top end. You can do that, and also you can do that on rabbit mode, L bunny, L hare. But on these trails, it's not too often you want to use that. But to switch it into high range, you put it in neutral. Got a bunny mode right here. Push that bunny and it'll shift her. Now I got me a little hare on there. Put her back in go mode. But she'll get a little wild on me. She'll take right off cruising, so that's mainly for if you got a close job you're moving to, or a nice, real nice, good haul road, which this right here is a good haul road, but I don't wanna fly down it. We've had a lot of rain lately. Don't wanna fly down it and splooge any, make any deeper tracks that I have to. So, but that's L hair mode. Put her back in neutral, push him again, back in L tortoise mode. Also, while you're driving, you got the blade operation. It's got a designated button or rocker switch here, and that's this one right here by your gear selector. Push forward goes down, pull back goes up. That's how you push on trucks or do some blading around the job site. Smooge over the roads and stuff like that. Other than that, there's not much for driving. You get into a hairy spot. Let's see, you can either lock your front lock, rear lock, or you can hold it right in the center here, and that will lock them all in, and you got full grunt mode, which ain't too bad. It'll get you out of a hairy situation. Let's see. If you want to do back blading, it's very nice to be able to float it. Like if you're just leveling something out, you're not trying to get the blade down to take the crust off or something. We got a button right here next to the thumb switch for the blade and the bunny and turtle mode. And you hold that, and it'll put a little blade here. See that blade's going down, and that is float. That means it's in float mode. You hold it again, it'll go off, and you raise her back up. So, not too bad. There's a few functions kicking around on this thing. See here, this time, alright, so now that I'm to one of my destinations out of many, you kind of move along the piles and grab what you're after, but there's a white button right here. You can tell which ones get used the most, but you push her, push him again, it'll kick this auto button right here, and now that that's active, I can push that one more time. It'll spin me around. It'll face my boom. That gets me in operation mode. and I can either just hit my boom button to kick activate my pumps, or my pump to allow me to operate that boom, or I can hit this min-max button one time, and it'll turn on my boom and turn on my working RPM. So until I touch the throttle, it'll idle. Yeah, all right, so if I touch anything or try to operate that boom, it'll kick me up on our operating RPM. And then that's where the work begins. Now we got on the right hand, this is my grapple close, down is grapple open. Main boom is on the right hand, how we have it set up. A lot of these are different for certain people like them a certain way and they can change them. And then a lot of time machines, you know, they come with their special operation. Each one's individual. Some of them are the same. I mean, just depends. And then on your left hand, you got your jib boom, which is brings it in by pulling back, and pushing away from you is pushing away from the boom, just like you would think it would be. And swing is on your left hand. That'll swing the boom side to side. Also, bucket rotate is on the right. Let's see, let's get it out here where you can see it. Rotate's on the right hand. Just like that. We got your open and close. And main boom. Left hand is, like I said, your swing. Jib boom in and out, or jib boom, yeah, however you want to say it. And then also this thumb switch on this side is your extension for your boom, which is pretty nice. And then much like while you're driving, you can dial that power up. You see it's at 44 right now. Got a plus button and a minus button right here. I push that, and that'll give me a little more oomph and a little more speed. Sometimes you turn it up, sometimes you turn it down, just depending on conditions or let's see what kind of wood you're grabbing. If you need a little more power to lift something nice and big, you dial her up a wee bit, give her a little more torque. And sometimes you're just too jumpy. If it's good and cold in the morning, you'll want to adjust that speed a little bit so you're not beating and banging on everything. And try and watch out for them stakes. Let's see. We'll grab some 10 foot, and then we'll also grab some bolts, some popple bolts. bang them up against that headache rack, and it'll straighten them out in case you got a couple. Which for some reason, we got the guy that operates that harvester. You don't always get them piles nice and even. Wouldn't be me though. You don't always get them nice and even, but as long as they're not mixed up too much, sometimes you gotta get her going and get some work done, so can't be too picky. Possible you try not to bring a bunch of crap up to the landing, because that's when you got to clean up your mess. I mean, it's just inevitable, you're gonna have some, but you grab something and there's a lot more brush or longer brush or something in it left over from a top from reaching over a pile and stacking something else on it, you know, it's gonna happen. But hey, kid.
Hi, Dad.
What you doing, bud?